You said you've joined a speaking group. Where? Is this online or is this in Vietnam?
Yeah, there is a cultural house in Ho Chi Minh City, and there is a speaking club. Yeah, I join him there every Sunday morning and evening.
Okay, and what sort of topics would you speak about in these speaking group sessions?
Yeah, anything. There's many kind of topic, and we talk about a job, life, and many things. Yeah, and we talk many things what we want to do.
Do you ever Skype with English speakers, let's say in North America or Australia, Britain? Do you ever practice with native English speakers?
No, this is the first time I'm gonna talk to you. Yeah, I
Okay.
know you're on Facebook. Yeah.
Good. Nice to good to talk to you. The
Yeah.
if I mean that would be one suggestion I would have if you are able to. Talk to, let's say, a Facebook friend or someone who has a friend through Facebook, let's say, in the US or Australia, Canada, who is willing to Skype, maybe someone
Yeah.
in your profession, or in or a student or someone who then you can have a conversation about something you're both interested in or something you're both familiar with. Then it's not just a made-up conversation about the weather, or something like that. But it's what a lot of people are doing now is using Skype
Right.
to,
Yeah.
just to do conversational practice.
Yes, I know. And yeah.
Do you feel comfortable? Will you feel comfortable doing this? Would you like to try to do that, to connect with other native English speakers elsewhere in the world via Skype?
Yeah, I'm a little bit nervous because my vocabulary is not good. It's not enough vocabulary to speak to other people. I have no vocabulary to show, to explain my idea with them. But I would try. I'm trying.
I moved from Thailand since 2005. I am a Canadian citizen.
So,
And
it looks like you're at a mall. Where are you?
yeah, animal, yeah, animal.
Oh, okay.
In Canada.
Yeah.
That's funny.
And next month, I will come back to English class, EAL at school. At school, but for right now, I prepare my English so that I will be very good English, and I will remember a lot of great words in my brain and listening. That then I search listening from VOA. I listen VOA, and it helped me a lot. And after that, I found this website. It is really good. And for right now, I study. Today I study at lesson 15. And I will be done by 16 for today.
I advise them to go through literatures, go through magazines, and get themselves accustomed to those words so that when you want to speak, it's going to be easy for you to just bring out words without thinking twice.
Yeah, my name is Namai, and I'm from Vietnam. I'm 17 years old, and I'm a high school student.
Okay, nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you, sir.
So our question today is, if you had just 1 hour a day to learn English, how would you spend it? How would you make the best use of that hour?
I will spend my time on listening English audio and learning vocabulary, and I write out to a notebook and from and take words from Oxford Advanced Learner's Dictionary.
Okay.
So
What sort of audio material would you listen to? What are your something that interests you? Maybe something related to your hobbies or something that you really need to do for school? What type of material would you listen to, and would it be something that you do at school, or you would do it sometimes at your own time?
I just do it sometimes as my hobby.
Okay.
So, yeah, when I have free time, and especially when I have time to learn English, so I'm listen to audio of VOA or BBC.
Do you listen to some songs online, or do you listen to something on TV, maybe on other media?
Oh, yeah. I usually listen to Maroon 5's song. Maroon 5.
Oh, Maroon 5.
I usually listen to the song, and then I go on internet and find the lyrics.
If you had just 1 hour to learn English every day, how would you spend that hour? What do you think would be the best use of that hour to learn English? What would you do?
Well, I guess at the beginning I would read during 15 minutes. Then the rest I could watch a video, or I can find out a new word. I have visiting a new website. I discovered one of these days that is called It's Western Dictionary. I can find very nice words sometimes, and I learn a lot from there.
Okay, when you find a word in the dictionary, do you find the word first and then try to use it, or do you find it because you find it somewhere in the video or in some text online, and then you want to look it up?
I find it first. For example, I am reading and I find a word. I don't know what it exactly means. So I try to find out the internet, how you use it,
okay,
when, and that's all. And what does it mean?
In Iran, I go to English class 2 days in a week. Okay?
Uh-huh. Okay.
Because now I have free time, for example, at night and afternoon, I have free time for learning English.
Great.
Okay? Yes, because I want to go to out of Iran for continuing education for master, because my major is in computer engineer.
Mm-hmm. All right.
Okay. Yes. And now I want to learn English for continuing education, because I need to learn English, because I want to get IELTS.
To take the IELTS test, yes, sure. Do you have a way to Skype with anyone to practice your English?
Yeah, I don't get you, but I think I want to learn English with Skype in Iran. Okay?
Yes.
It's true?
Yes. That's our question.
Do you have a way to connect with people through social media?
Yes. I have either ID Facebook, and have an ID Skype and Yahoo. yes, I have.
Okay. So, have you made friends? Have you met people online via Skatebook, Skype or Facebook? maybe we'll have Skatebook.
Yeah, that's
one
right.
Day.
That's right. I'll combine it both. You can talk right through the.
Right. Have you met people who you already were able to practice your English with?
In Skype?
Yes. Or Facebook?
Yes. I have a friend in Otaf, Iran. And I connected with them for learning English.
Welcome to Talk to Us with Jelka and Avi. Good
Hi.
To have you calling. So it's been 5 months since we last spoke to you. How have you been learning English? What have you been doing to improve your English?
I'm just working on my thesis and do not have any time to work on my general English, because I'm doing my thesis and it takes much time. And after that, I'll do it again.
Okay, what is your thesis on?
My thesis is about English language teaching.
All right.
I'm comparing two groups. One is about computer-based material, English teaching by computer-based material.
Okay.
And the other, English teaching by printed-based material.
Mm. All right. So you're comparing these two methods of teaching. You're probably an ideal... Sorry?
In a rural setting.
I see. I see. So you are probably an ideal person to ask this question, right?
That's right. Well, I'm curious, how do you compare print materials in a rural setting? How do you compare learning with print materials versus learning with online materials?
Would you please turn your camera off, because the quality is going to be low and worse.
Okay, I just turned our camera off. So how do you think those two, the two different methods of learning compare?
Now, I just compared these two and I gained a very different result according to the previous studies.
And so what's your conclusion? Is there one that's better than the other, or what's your summary?
The previous studies said that English teaching based on computer-based materials works better than printed-based, okay?
Mm-hmm.
All right.
But as mine was done in a rural setting, as the facilities was not good enough in a rural setting for the students.
Sure.
And all the students were engaged with just another computer applications, and they do not pay more attention about language teaching and learning.
Mm-hmm.
And my result was inconsistent with the other studies.